S11 performance. The impedance matching measurement of the antennas was carried out using the Agilent N5230A vector network analyzer. Figure 3 shows the simulated and measured return loss. The proposed antenna exhibits broadband impedance bandwidth. The frequency range for minus 15 dB return loss is from 826 to 950 MHz or 124 MHz bandwidth. The measured result agrees well with the simulation. S11 of the actual antenna and simulation model. Far-field gain and directivity. The far-field gain and directivity are shown in Figure 4. It is clear that the gain is lower than minus 10 dB at any direction and about 15 dB lower than directivity. A. Far-field gain versus theta at different phi, which is 0, 90, 180 and 270 degrees, and marked by 4 curves. B. Directivity versus theta at different phi, which is same as A. Current distribution. Figure 5 shows the current distribution of different phases. Different from conventional traveling wave antenna, current on the loop assumes standing wave distribution. One important factor of current is in phase. Because magnetic field produced by the currents on the adjacent sides of the antenna cancel out each other and is thus very weak in the central portion of interrogation zone if the current distribution is out phase. In Figure 5, current of this antenna is not out phase because of small electrical length of the quasi-half loop. At the phases of 45, 90 and 135 degree, the currents are all strong. Actually, the magnetic field at these phases are also strong. The result could be verified by the comparison between figures 5 and 6. Current distribution on metal strip at different phases, A 0 degrees, B 45 degrees, C 90 degrees and D 135 degrees. Different phases offs orientation magnetic field distribution on the reference plane which is 1 cm above the top of antenna, A 0 degrees, B 45 degrees, C 90 degrees and D 135 degrees. Magnetic field distribution. Figure 6 shows that magnetic field is concentrated and uniform around the center region of antenna at different phases, 0 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, 135 degrees. Moreover, as a result of folded terminal, average current can be enhanced on the outer loop so that strong magnetic field intensity is obtained. Figure 7a shows the magnetic field distribution at difference above the surface of antenna's top. The reason for choosing such a graduation scale is narrowly related with reading taggability, which will be discussed later. Figure 7b focuses on the magnetic field intensity attenuation versus z-axis. Simulated magnetic field distribution of the antenna operated at 868 MHz, a z-orientation magnetic field distribution at difference. Radius of reference plane is also 50 mm and, b, magnetic field intensity of the antenna's along axis. Compared to other antenna, it could be found that the z-orientation magnetic field of the new antenna is much stronger. For example, referred by Figure 7b, the magnetic field of this antenna is significantly stronger than that of the proposed traveling wave antenna in that same z. At z equals 2 cm, 2-layer and 2 quasi-half loops antenna has magnetic field intensity of minus 3 dB/m, whereas the antenna from has only minus 15 dB/m. Taking Figure 7a as a reference, the magnetic field in center region of the antenna is also stronger than the another broadband antenna which is proposed by Ching et al. It shows that magnetic field of the antenna from is lower than minus 10 dB/m at z equals half a millimeter, whereas 2-layer and 2 quasi-half loops antenna is stronger than 0 dB/m although at z equals 1 cm.